2017 was a defining year for Malayalam cinema, which had many great films with great content becoming both critically and commercially successful compared to the regular star vehicles. The unanimous choice for the best film of the year would definitely be Thondimuthalum Driksakshiyum. Dilish Pothan's second film after the National Award winning Maheshinte Prathikaram starred Fahad Fasil, Nimisha Sajayan and Suraj Vennaramudu. A role reversal of sorts happened when Fahad Fasil, the star, played a thief in the film and a character actor like Suraj Vennaramudu played the protagonist. A layered story with a lot of subtle humor talked about a lot of issues like caste, hunger, politics and the policing system and won the hearts of both critics and the audience. Takeoff, directed by Mahesh Narayanan, was a gritty story of survival which was based on the 2014 evacuation of nurses from Iraq. The film had a phenomenal performance by the leading actress Parvati, supported by actors like Kunjako Boban, Fahad Fasil and Asif Ali. It had a great script, a very well-defined, strong female protagonist, brilliant production values, staying within the constraints of Malayala cinema's budgets. This film was a clear example of a great script becoming a winner at the box office.
Indian ambassador. Hospital no-fire zone la. Rikshikindhanekal kudal riskan avar transport yendu. Oray avar exit route, Abel airport on.
Let's drop this.
Angamaly Diaries, directed by Lijo Jose Pellicheri, became a sensation all over India. An infectiously energetic gangster flick which had no known actors but instead had 86 newcomers playing all the important roles. It was a very daring step by the director and it became really successful. The film showcased the life of the people in Angamaly, the culture there, the dialects there, the food there, the alcohol there, the kind of humor the people use over there. It was all showcased very beautifully, along with a stunning 11-minute long single shot climax, which was nothing short of spellbinding. And the film proved that you don't need superstars to create a super fantastic movie. And that was nothing short of revolutionary in Malayalam cinema. Rakshadhikari, Baiju, Oppu, directed by Ranjan Pramod, didn't really have a conventional storyline. It narrated the daily lives and incidents that happen around a playground in a village called Kumbulam and the lives of the people associated with it. Biju Menon played a lovable character called Baiju, a government official who is very attached to that ground. The movie had a lot of nostalgic elements in it, lovely music and beautiful performance from the entire supporting cast. It was a movie that defied all the conventional norms of screenplay writing as well and also went on to become a very big hit. Parava was the directorial debut of actor Saubin Shahir, which narrated the story of two boys from Mattancheri completely focused on winning a competition in pigeon flying. The film showcased the life in Mattancheri very realistically and had a huge star cast which was a mix of both new and veteran actors. Even the pigeons were characters in the movie. The film also had a very charming cameo by Dulkar Salman, and Saubin cleverly used Dulkar's star power to take the story of these two boys to a wider audience. There were also other interesting films like Nyandukalde Naattil Oru Idavela, Maya Nadi, Goda, Adventures of Omina Kutten, Care of Sarah Banu and Udaharanam Sujada, which clearly focused on content over star power. And we can clearly say that 2017 has been a great year for Malayalam cinema.